Hi, my name is Nick. I'm an alcoholic. Shoot, wrong meeting, but I recognize some faces, goddammit. Actually, my name is unimportant, but the name of the person who founded the company who are presenting this award is incredibly important, as is the name of the recipient. And those two people are, respectively, the late, great Jim Marshall and the one, the only Lita Ford. Both of these people are not only legends, they're also icons. And those are two highly laudable, and actually they're badges of honor. Those are badges of honor. And you have to earn those. You can't demand those. A title does not give you that shit. Sorry, I can't say that word, title. You have to earn this stuff, and the only way you earn it is those honors are bestowed on you by others and others alone. If you tell people you're a legend, you're not. Your name is Richard, but with the short sense with a D at the start. Also, Lita and Jim are not only just legends and icons, they're pioneers. In my humble opinion, Lita Ford is the first lady of rock guitar, period. She's also the matriarch of female metal guitar. No one else comes close. She just didn't open the door and carve a pathway. She kicked the goddamn door off its hinges, and she used dynamite, not a shovel, to make that path so others could follow her. And one of those who's followed really, really well is the one and only Lizzie Hale from Hailstorm. She can't be here tonight, but thanks to the wonder of the internet and video and all that wonderful stuff, she's on the video screen. So enough of my nonsense and my ugly face, let's go to the video.
Hey everybody, I'm Lizzie Hale from Hailstorm, and I am in Auckland, New Zealand. I have had the utmost privilege of touring and sharing stage with Lita Ford, and I can tell you not only is she an inspiration as a musician, but she's also just such a wonderful person. So, Lita, even though I can't be with you tonight, congratulations on the She Rocks Icon Award. No one deserves it more, and thank you so much for carving out a path for women rockers like me to pick up a guitar and make some love you, girl.
Lizzie Hale. Now, I wasn't going to say this because it's being streamed, but thanks to Shirley Manson. Great speech, by the way, young lady. And she is anything but a stupid girl. I'm going to say this. Steve, I mentioned guys who dressed like women in the 80s. I was not one of them. I was too goddamn ugly. But there's one difference between Lita Ford and those guys that try to look like women, and it's simply this. She played with bigger balls than any of them. Anybody got any questions or problems with that statement? Because it's the goddamn truth. Now, it's said that England and America are two countries divided by a common language. You say trunk, we say boot. You say elevator, we say lift. You say cigarette, I can't say what we say. Some of you got that, cool. You say CEO, we say managing director. It gives me great pleasure. Here to present the Icon Award is Marshall Amplifications managing director John Ellery and his charming wife Ellie. Over to you guys.
Just comes to me to say, Lita, you've inspired a generation. I am honored that you're part of the Marshall family, and it gives me great privilege to present this award to you.
I wasn't going to say anything, but it's Lita Ford!
Thank you. What a great speech. Oh, my God. And Lizzie. Miss Lizzie Hale. Yeah, we just did a tour with them. She was awesome. 40 years I've been in the music industry. 40 years. I have to give this award to the Runaways, because the Runaways really started. Yeah. They got so many people going, and they were so before their time. 1976, we started, we had our first album out, and nobody took us serious. Nobody could believe that five women could go out and kick ass like we did. We had Joan Jett in the band, Sandy West, Cherie Curry, Jackie Fox, and I played guitar. Nobody could believe that I was the guitar player. They thought we had somebody hiding behind the curtain playing guitar. So then I started my solo project 5 years later. I went solo, and I put together a three-piece band because I wanted to prove to the world that a woman could play guitar. So I got rid of the guys that played guitar in my band, and it was just myself on guitar, a bass player, and a drummer, a la Jimi Hendrix style. And I was signed within 3 months. I got my first record contract. But then the label didn't know how to market me because I was a guitar player, not just a singer, but a guitar player. I seemed to have this trouble throughout my entire life. At one point or another, people would get confused and not know how to market me. I was like, well, you can market Joe Perry, you can market all these other great bands, but you can't market me when I'm actually doing the same thing as what they're doing. I'm playing guitar. The only difference is they were their balls here, and we were our balls up here. That's the only difference. So anyway, 40 years of rocking and 40 years of not taking no for an answer. We do what we want to do because it's in our blood and we love it. And I couldn't have done it without these people here, John and Ellie, Nick, Marshall Amplification, Bernie Rico Sr., who created BC Rich Guitars. Some of the finest guitars I've ever played. I'm going to play one in a few minutes. Dean Markley's guitar strings, they have a Lita Ford signature model, which is pretty killer if you want to check out some new strings. I've got the Runaways down here because Kim Fowley, what an eccentric man he was, but he had a vision to create this teenage, all-girl, jailbait, rebellious group of monster teenage girls. And we lived up to our reputation and we loved every second of it. Troublemakers. Team Lita, we've got Josh Fettick and Bobby Collin, my band, Patrick Kennison, Marty O'Brien, and Bobby Rock. My producer, Gary Hoey, and I want to thank Lon Friend, because Lon Friend was the first man to put a woman on the cover of RIP magazine, on a rock magazine. They would not put a woman on the cover of a rock magazine until Lon came along and he just said, screw it. Boom, there's Lita. It was the largest selling issue of the year. Yep. And Laura Whitmore, thank you so much for putting on this event, Laura. And I want to thank parade.com for the live stream. And I think it's time to rock.